Under Title 17 of the U.S. Code, Section 501 and 506, the use and redistribution of copyrighted materials without the owner's consent is punishable by both civil and criminal law, making piracy in America illegal. With the birth of the Internet, at the dawn of the digital age, these laws would face new threats, ones that would test their boundaries like never before, creating a world where crime is prime time. Through sites such as the Pirate Bay and Kick-Ass Torrents, we have been able to freely download movies, games, music, and software at no charge. Until now. Prosecutors have formally charged Artem Balin, a 30-year-old Ukrainian man, with one count of conspiracy to commit criminal copyright infringement, one count of conspiracy to commit money laundering, and two counts of criminal copyright infringement. He is currently awaiting extradition in Poland, where he was captured July 20th of this year to the United States, but as of 7 p.m. this very day, has been denied access to defense attorney Ira Rofkin. Part of a joint task force, the Department of Treasury, the Department of Homeland Security, and the Internal Revenue Service have seized Balin's accounts, frozen his assets, and shut down Kick-Ass Torrents. Balin is accused of running today's most visited illegal file-sharing website, responsible for unlawfully distributing well over $1 billion of copyrighted materials, says Assistant Attorney General Caldwell. Kick-Ass Torrents, like the Pirate Bay, provides .magnetic links as well as .torrent links for direct access to unauthorized materials instead of hosting individual illegal files on their servers. Instead, these files are downloaded from individual users across the globe. Caldwell goes on to say that in an effort to evade law enforcement, Balin allegedly relied on servers located in countries around the world and moved his domains due to repeated seizures and civil lawsuits, and that his arrest in Poland demonstrates again that cyber criminals can run, but they cannot hide from justice. The ongoing prosecution of Balin in Poland is only a minute fraction of the overall epidemic. Every day, sites like Mega Upload, 4shared, YouTube, and Spotify are circulating illegal materials at an unimaginable rate, leaving the consumer in bliss and the music industry in ruins. Short of wrecking the internet and cutting off our lifelines, what can we do? Well, it needs to start with our federal government. For years, our government has turned a blind eye and allowed the skull and crossbones to fly freely across America, leading to the complete and utter annihilation of the music industry. Piracy is at an all-time high, with 63% of people downloading illegally. That's two out of three of us in this class. Online file sharing is now nearly three times higher than every dollar spent on those same items worldwide. For instance, if the music industry globally produces $1 billion in revenue, nearly $3 billion is given away through file sharing. This, along with the 63% downloading illegally, the music industry has went from a $15 billion a year titan in 1999 to flat broke in the year 2019. Extinct. My passion. Annihilated. Piracy, since the days of Blackbeard and Davy Jones, has held a sense of mystique and intrigue, as portrayed in Treasure Island, with X marking the spot to wealth and gold. Instead, it should be treated like the crime that it is, as captains should be made to walk the plank to give the keel a nice hauling, or as Valen faces up to 20 years in a federal prison, where the only thing he'll be singing is the blues. We have options. Along with watermarking, digital fingerprinting of copyrighted goods is beginning to make itself known. Instead of the billions we spend in litigation, we should spend those dollars securing what we love and work so hard to bring to life. We have the opportunity to revolutionize the music industry instead of watching it die. The day of big labels are over, and the power is in the hand of the artist for the first time in history. Let's take our creative minds and sculpt our hopes and dreams from the rubble left from those pillaging pirates and christen a new era. The era of the digital producing artist who has control of every aspect of his creation instead of selling for a stripped down rendition from some guy